Hello, my dear students. I welcome you all to my English class. So, very first thing you are going to put today is date. And on the red line, write your chapter's name. At the zoo. CW on the top. We are going to write some new words of the chapter. Leave the first line, write on the second line new words. And number one, first word is rubber. RUBBER, rubber. RUBBER, rubber. Rubber is a material. Okay, it is a material from which bone is made. Okay, artificial bone, that is not the real bone, B-O-N-E, bone. Who was playing with this rubber bone? Spot. Okay, Spot was playing with the rubber bone. It is an artificial bone made of rubber. Okay, it is made for dogs. Write nicely, children. Check out the lines. B, you have to start from upper red line and take it till lower blue line in both the words. Rest all the letters are to be written between two blue lines. And the third one, asleep, A-S-L-E-E-P, asleep. Asleep means sleeping. In your sleep, that is asleep. When somebody is sleeping, we can say he is asleep. Right, children? Come to number four. Number four is trip. C-H-I-R-P, trip. The birds trip, right? And what do they trip? What do they say? They say twit. T-W-E-E-T, twit. They take out the sound twit, twit, and we call it as trip, right? So the first one is rubber, R-U-B-B-E-R, rubber. Rubber is a material from which the bone is made, that is artificial bone made for dogs to play with. Okay, second one is bone, B-O-N-E, bone. When we keep the pet dog, we take rubber bone so that they can play with it. Like we play with the toy, so they also play with the rubber bone. They like it very much. And the third one is asleep. A-S-L-E-E-P, asleep. Someone is sleeping, we say they are asleep. Now, who were asleep? In our chapter at the zoo, who was sleeping? The tiger. Tiger is asleep, right? And the fourth one, C-H-I-R-P, chirp. The birds chirp. Twit, twit. How do the birds chirp? Twit, twit. So, the sound of bird is twit, twit. And we call it as chirp. When somebody asks you what is the sound of a bird, then we are going to say chirp. And they actually take out the sound as twit, twit. Fine. Number 6 is roar. R-O-A-R, roar. Sixth word is roar. Check out the spelling. R-O-A-R, roar. All the four letters you have to write between the two blue lines. And what is roar? Roar is the sound of lion. The lion roars. Okay, the sound of lion we call it as roar. Let's write the next word, number 7. Hiss. H-I-S-S, hiss. H you have to start from upper red line, take it till lower blue line. Rest three letters you have to write between the two lines and put a title on the top of I. Now what is hiss? H-I-S-S, hiss. As roar is the sound of lion, chirp is the sound of a bird. Similarly, hiss is a sound of a snake. Sound of snake is called hiss. Manu and Meeta went to the zoo and they all heard all these things. They heard the lion roaring, they heard the snake hiss, and also they heard the twit twit, that is tripping of the birds. We come to number 8. Number 8 is waves. W-A-V-E-S, waves. All the letters you have to write between the two blue lines. Waves. The monkey waves his long tail. What do you mean by waves? Monkey is waving his tail, that is moving. Moving his tail from here to there, that is called waves. The monkey waves his long tail. That is the monkey moving his tail. Similarly, we are going to write the 9th one, which have a similar meaning, shakes. Don't be in a hurry, children. I will give you enough time to write. Just write it neat and clean. Your book should look very neat and clean, okay? Don't be in a hurry. So, what is our 9th word? Shakes. S-H-A-K-E-S, shakes. As the monkey is moving his tail, he waves his tail. Similarly, the crocodile shakes its tail, okay? That is the movement of a crocodile, okay? Crocodile is shaking its tail. here the monkey is waving his tail and here the crocodile is shaking its tail. Both means that they are moving their tail here and there. Right? And we come to the last word, number 10. And the 10th word is lift. L-I-F-T-S, lift. The elephant lifts his long nose. Now here, monkey and crocodile is waving their tail, moving their tails. What is the elephant doing? The elephant is lifting his long nose. Lifting means moving upward. Okay. This waves and shakes can be either right to left, left to right. But when we say lift, that means upward. Taking the nose in a upward direction. So, what is the elephant doing? The elephant lifts his long nose. So, hereby we complete our 10 new words, children. Complete your work. Thank you so much.